See compensators. Next is your compensator. We have two types of compensator: lead compensator, lag compensator, and lag lead compensator. And lag lead compensator or lead lag compensator. Both are same only. Okay, only one which is lag lead compensator. Lead compensator is depending on the location of this zeros and poles. जो कि जीरो एंड फोर्स में आइडेंटिफाई द करस्पॉन्डिंग कंपेंसेटर ओके करस्पॉन्डिंग कंपेंसेटर फॉर लीड कंपेंसेटर जीरो टू बी अपीयर फर्स्ट देन द पोल जीरो टू बी अपीयर फर्स्ट देन द पोल फॉर लैग कंपेंसेटर पोल टू बी अपीयर देन जीरो एंड फॉर द लैग लीड कंपेंसेटर लैग कंपेंसेटर फॉलोड बाय योर लीड कंपेंसेटर फॉलोड बाय योर lead compensator. First of all, discussing we start with the lead compensator. The corresponding electrical equivalent for the lead compensator is given by like this. This is your R1, R2 and C. This is your capacitor C, the input signal. Here is some input signal and this is the output signal we are considering from. Output signal we will take from here. Output is equal to here. So the corresponding format of this lead compensator equal to alpha of 1 plus Ts upon 1 plus alpha Ts, 1 plus alpha Ts, where alpha is the attenuation constant, which is equal to R2 divided by R1 plus R2, R2 divided by R1 plus R2, which is less than 1. Okay, R2 divided by R1 plus R2, which is less than 1, and the corresponding T is equal to R1 into C. The corresponding T or tau is equal to R1 into C. What is the zero of this one? Zero of this one is equal to location at the minus 1 by T. Zero is located at the minus 1 by T. Zero is existed at S is equal to minus 1 by T. And the corresponding pole is at S is equal to minus 1 by alpha T. And alpha is less than 1. Definitely this value is greater than this 1 by T. The magnitude of this 1 by alpha T is definitely greater than this 1 by T. Don't remember this formula as a standard form. Notation is equal to like this only. Alpha 1 plus Ts by 1 plus alpha Ts. But don't try to remember. Remember as it is. Just remember the point for the lead compensator. Zero to be appear first, then the pole. Zero is first, then the pole. Okay, zero is first, then pole is next of zero. Then the corresponding system is the lead compensator. Just remember like that only. Something they will give you the standard now without you. Don't consider the standard form. Okay, they will give you the question is the expression for the lead compensator GC of S is given by expression for the sum compensator GC of S is given by S plus 3 upon S plus 5 S plus 3 upon S plus 5. Then what is the which of the following is a suitable compensator? Which of the following represents the given compensator? Lead compensator, lag compensator, like that they will give you. At that situation, you have to identify whichever is the first. If zero is appear first, the corresponding is the lead compensator. If pole is appear first, the corresponding will be the lag compensator. That's it. Don't remember any expressions. If they ask you, they given alpha 1 plus T by 1 plus alpha Ts and the corresponding alpha is equal to what? If they ask you, then only it will require the alpha is called an attenuation constant. This time is your time constant. So this is equal to R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Now, how the polar plot will be? At omega equal to 0, what is the magnitude and what is the pace? What is the magnitude here? Magnitude is equal to alpha into square root of 1 plus T square upon. Magnitude is equal to alpha into square root of 1 plus t square omega square divided by 1 plus alpha square t square omega square. 1 plus alpha square t square omega square with the square root. If omega equal to 0, then what is the value? If omega is equal to 0, simply the magnitude is equal to alpha. At omega equal to 0. And what about omega equal to infinity? What about the value? If you take this into the inside, alpha plus alpha t j omega divided by 1 plus alpha t j omega. Or in this one, if you take this omega is taken as out. So omega into 1 by omega plus t, 1 by omega plus t. And if you take this omega square as the outside, what you will get? This alpha t omega, alpha t divided by alpha t, the corresponding is equal to 1 only. Nothing is there. If you take this omega as a common, alpha omega square root of 1 plus t, 1 by omega square, 1 plus t divided by, you take this alpha omega square as a common, this you get square root of 1 by omega square plus alpha square t square, alpha square t square. By substituting this omega equal to infinity, what you will get here, this equal to alpha t divided by alpha t, which is equal to 1. Alpha t divided by alpha t, which is equal to 1 only. Okay, so the corresponding magnitude here is equal to 1. Now, what about the pace?
At t equal to 0, the phase equal to t equal to 0, the phase will be 0 only, since tan inverse of omega t minus phase is equal to tan inverse of omega t minus tan inverse of alpha omega t, tan inverse of alpha omega t. At omega equal to 0, the corresponding phase is equal to 0 only, corresponding phase is equal to 0 only. At omega equal to infinity, corresponding phase is 90 minus 90, 90 minus 90, which is equal to 0, which is equal to 0. Now, if you represent this in the polar plot, at omega equal to 0, this value is equal to some alpha. Some alpha at omega equal to 0, and omega to infinity some 1. So definitely alpha is less than 1. And if you are for any some intermediate values, this value is going to be positive. Listen, here we have tan inverse omega t. For some omega equal to 5 I am considering, some omega equal to some value greater than 0 I am considering. Here tan inverse of omega t minus tan inverse of alpha omega t, as alpha is less than 1, because of this alpha less than 1 alpha makes this omega, this total term to be less than the omega t. Definitely the angle should be positive only. As omega is going to be increases. Getting or not? Since this is some omega t, I am considering as some 5. Omega t, total omega t equal to some 5. And alpha is equal to some 0.5. Okay, alpha is equal to some 0.5. This 0.5 into 5, it makes 0.25. Definitely, the angle appeared from this one is less than the angle appeared from this one, definitely. So, the overall angle will be positive only. So, as alpha is omega is varying from 0 to infinity, the shape of this polar plot is equal to like this only. Okay, like this only. This is equal to value at omega equal to infinity. This is the value at omega equal to infinity. Okay, this is very, very important. In options, they will give you different shapes. Okay, in reverse way, they will give you one, they will place one here and they will place alpha there. Like that, they may ask you. Then, what about the border plan for this one? Alpha 1 plus Ts by 1 plus alpha Ts. Here, alpha is there. Here alpha is there, so some 0, initially equal to 0 slope, and the corresponding magnitude is equal to 20 log alpha, up to what frequency, you have to represent the frequencies in the increasing order, first 0 followed by your pole, so here equal to corresponding is equal to 1 by, the corresponding 0 equal to 1 by t, 1 by corresponding, the omega n is equal to 1 by t here. Now, after this, this value equal to, next one equal to 1 by alpha t, because of this alpha less than 1, definitely this 1 by alpha t is greater than this one only. At 1 by t, we are having 1 0, because of this 0, the slope is become 20 dB per decade after this omega, after this Carnot frequency, 1 by t. Now the corresponding after this, at 1 by alpha t, you are having again one more pole here. So this pole introduces what by r dB minus 20 dB. Thus minus 20 dB plus this 20 dB, you have 0 dB. Already we done some questions on the border plot, not required much clear information. Okay, initial slope is equal to 0, the corresponding amplitude is equal to simply over 20 log alpha. Up to what value? Up to the Carnot frequency, which Carnot frequency? Okay, up to the Carnot frequency, which Carnot frequency? The least Carnot frequency, which is equal to 1 by t. 1 by t is the 0 as the factor in the numerator. So it introduces some more slope equal to 20 dB. That 0 plus 20 dB, that means 20 dB. And if 1 by alpha is a pole, it introduces slope of minus 20 dB. So 20 dB minus 20 dB, we have 0 dB. This is the corresponding border plot for this one. And if you consider this alpha is equal to 1, then 1 plus Ts divided by 1 plus alpha Ts is equal to what? Is equal to 1. Okay? Control is equal to 1. Or if you multiply this alpha with the, or if you to make this 20 log alpha to be 0, then it will look like this one only. That nothing but it allows the higher frequencies than the one suspends lower frequencies. So we can call this active, we can say this act as a high pass filter. So lead compensator can be act as a high pass filter. Suppose if you add some dB of this amount, it's called 20 log alpha, minus 20 log alpha, then if you make this term to be 0, okay, 20 log alpha to be 0, then the correspondingly the plot shifts like this, the like this, or if you multiply with the 0.1 or something, okay, already we have seen, if you multiply some constant of less than 1, then the plot shifts downwards, okay, I am making some multiplication with some constant to shift this plot to the downwards by 20 log alpha amount, then the corresponding plot shifts like this, looks like this, and it is looking like a hyperspectral only, okay, it suspends the lower frequencies and allows the higher frequencies, so we can call the lead compensator acts as a high pass filter. Lead compensator acts as a high pass filter. Okay, the points what you have to remember is that here lead acts as a high pass filter. First one is the zero. First zero followed by your pole. And the correspondingly the polar plot is this one, border plot is this one, and it acts as a high pass filter. Okay, you are saying that this is the lead compensator. Here, where the corresponding pi is equal to like this only. Here the pi is equal to 0 and here the pi is equal to 0. At some frequency, this pi will become a maximum value. At what frequency the pi will be maximum? And what is the maximum pi? What is the maximum pi you need to calculate? Okay, you need to calculate. This is very important. They are asking at what frequency the maximum lead may occur, maximum base angle may occur, and what is the maximum base angle. Okay, for anything, don't remember any formula. Okay, for suppose I am calculating that analysis using this counter function alpha 1 plus ts divided by 1 plus alpha ts. In examination, they will give you in a different manner. Okay, they will give you a different manner. At that time also, do the analysis. Don't remember any formula. What we have to do? We have to calculate at what frequency the maximum pace may exist and what is the maximum pace at that frequency. For maximum or minimum, what will we do actually in the mathematics point of view? For maximum or minimum, the differentiation divide by dx is equal to 0. Here also, transformation equal to alpha 1 plus t, 1 plus alpha ds. The corresponding pi is equal to tan inverse of omega t minus tan inverse of alpha omega t, tan inverse of omega t minus tan inverse of alpha omega t by substituting s equal to j omega. It will become alpha of 1 plus j omega t upon 1 plus j alpha omega t, 1 plus j alpha omega t. From this the corresponding base equal to tan inverse of omega t minus tan inverse of alpha omega t. Okay, for getting the maximum or minimum, we have to do the differentiation. Of d pi by d omega is equal to 0. D pi by d omega equal to 0. Okay, by doing the differentiation, this is equal to 1 upon 1 plus omega square t square into t minus 1 upon 1 plus alpha square omega square t square into alpha t is equal to 0. From this we can write this is equal to 1 by 1 plus omega square t square is equal to 1 by equal to alpha divided by 1 plus alpha square omega square t square. Alpha square omega square t square. By doing cross multiplication, we have 1 plus alpha square omega square t square is equal to alpha plus alpha omega square t square. Alpha plus alpha omega square t square. Right or wrong? Is there anything? Tan inverse of omega t is equal to simply 1 by 1 plus omega square t square, and differentiation of this omega t is equal to t minus tan inverse of alpha omega t equal to tan inverse of alpha omega t equal to 1 by 1 plus alpha square omega square t square into alpha t. Now, what do you have here? So by taking simply cross multiply, equating to 0, so this is equal to 1 plus alpha square omega square t square is equal to alpha plus alpha into omega square t square. So this can be represented as 1 by, this can be represented as by taking alpha omega square t square as the common, alpha minus 1 is equal to alpha minus 1. So from this, we can write this omega square is equal to 1 by alpha t square and omega equal to 1 by t root alpha. This is the frequency where the maximum pace will occur. What are the corner frequencies we are having? One by t and one by alpha t. Okay, here we got omega is equal to 1 by t root alpha. So we can say the maximum pace occurs at omega is equal to geometric mean of the corner frequency. No need to do any analysis. Okay, for any question, no need to do any analysis. Simply is equal to geometric mean of the corner frequency. So this is equal to 1 by alpha into 1 by alpha t with the square root. This is equal to 1 by 1 by t is equal to 1 by t root alpha is your 1 by t root alpha is your frequency where the maximum pace may occurs. Okay, maximum pace may occurs. Now, what is the maximum volume? What is the maximum pace? Maximum pace means simply substitution of this omega in the given frequency, in the given substitution of this omega in the given frequency. Directly you may get this corresponding pi is equal to tan inverse of omega equal to what? 1 by t root alpha into t minus tan inverse of alpha into 1 by t root alpha into t. 1 by t root alpha into t. From this you can say t get cancelled and this t get cancelled. What you will get? This equal to tan inverse of 1 by root alpha minus tan inverse of root alpha. From this directly this equal to tan inverse of 1 by root alpha minus root alpha divided by 1 plus 1 by root alpha into root alpha, which is equal to 1 plus 1. Tan inverse of a minus b divided by 1 plus ab. Tan inverse of a minus b divided by 1 plus ab. From this you can write this equal to tan inverse of 1 minus alpha divided by 2 root alpha. Tan inverse of 1 minus alpha divided by 2 root alpha. If you convert this into the sine format, you are having this equal to, this is, if you consider this as a right angle, the corresponding is your 1 minus alpha and 2 root alpha. And 2 root alpha. This value is equal to square root of 1 plus 1 minus alpha whole square plus 4 alpha. 2 root alpha. 1 minus alpha whole square plus 4 alpha. This is equal to square root of 1 plus alpha whole square. This is equal to 1 plus alpha. From this, if you represent in form of the sine, this is equal to sine theta is equal to 1 minus alpha by 1 plus alpha. And theta is equal to sine inverse of 1 minus alpha by 1 plus alpha. This is the formula you may see in the books. Okay, and don't remember this formula anywhere and don't use this formula anywhere. Okay, this theta is equal to sine inverse of 1 minus alpha divided by 1 plus alpha is the maximum theta for the lead compensator. In the questions, definitely you expect a questions at what value, at what frequency the maximum pace will occur and what is that maximum pace. Okay, at that situation, simply the maximum pace occurs at the frequency is equal to geometric mean of the corner frequencies. Geometric mean of the corner frequencies only. Or geometric mean of poles, you can say. Geometric means of the pole and the zero. Here zero equal to minus 1 by t and pole is equal to minus 1 by alpha t, which is equal to geometric mean of the pole and zero. And the corresponding pace mean? Simply substitute this value, whatever you are getting this omega in the pace expression, and whatever the answer you will get, that will be the final answer. If you want to remember sine inverse of 1 minus alpha by 1 plus alpha, then you have to convert the given transfer function into the standard form as alpha 1 plus ts divided by 1 plus alpha ts. It is unnecessary time. Okay, by the conversion into this type, and after getting the value of alpha, then by calculating the theta maximum, by placing into sine inverse of 1 minus alpha, 1 plus alpha, what is the necessity? This is not a, no need to remember or no need to consider this as a new topic, this rate compensator with respect to gate point of view. Of course, the rate compensator is like compensator controllers plays a very, very key role in the design in the control systems. That is to read the given specifications of the control system, what compensator to be used, what the value of alpha to be taken, what type of compensator, lay compensator or lag compensator, which compensator to be used is very, very, and the corresponding controller to avoid the corresponding errors, which controller to be placed, proportional or integral or differential, and those are placed very, very important role in the designing of a control system, but the gate syllabus point of view, the mathematical analysis of this, the rigid compensator, lag compensator and the lagging compensator, those are enough. So we cannot treat, we are not supposed to treat as a new topic in the control system. Simple mathematics only. Only point is the for lead compensator, zero to appear first, then the pole. For lag compensator, pole to be appear first, then the zero. That is it. And now consider the lag compensator here. For the lag compensator here is equal to 1 plus ts divided by 1 plus beta ts equal to 1 plus ts divided by 1 plus beta ts. The corresponding electrical equivalent is equal to your R2 here, this is your R1, this is your capacitor, and the corresponding input is equal to here, and the corresponding output they have taken at that place. Now the corresponding transfer function is equal to 1 plus ts divided by 1 plus beta ts. Here beta is equal to R1 plus R2 divided by R2, which is equal to 1 by alpha. Which is, as alpha is less than 1, here beta is greater than 1, here beta is greater than 1. What is the location of the pole here? Location of the pole is equal to minus 1 by beta t. Location of the 0 equal to minus 1 by t. Since beta is greater than 1 here, so because of that, the pole will appears, if pole will appear first then the zero. In earlier case, pole is equal to minus 1 by alpha t, minus 1 by alpha t, and alpha is less than 1. So, alpha less than 1, the total term will become greater than the 1 by t. So, the zero will appear first then the pole. Here, this beta is greater than this one. Beta is greater than 1. 1 by beta t is the less than value than the 1 by t. So pole will appear first than the 0. Pole will appear first than the 0. This is your corresponding integrator. Corresponding integrator. What is the, how would be the polar pattern for this one? What is the magnitude here? Magnitude is equal to 1 plus t square or square root of 1 plus t square upon 1 plus beta square t square omega square. 1 plus t square omega square divided by 1 plus beta square t square omega square. What is the pace here? Pace is equal to simply tan inverse of omega t minus tan inverse of beta omega t. Tan inverse of beta omega t. Now, from this omega equal to 0, what is the magnitude? And from omega equal to infinity, what is the magnitude? Calculate the corresponding values and try to draw the polar plot. And similarly, try to represent during the border plot also. At omega equal to 0, what is the magnitude here? Magnitude is equal to simply 1 only. Whatever the pace, some pace is equal to tan inverse of 0 minus 0, 0 only. Okay, at omega equal to infinity, by taking omega square as the common, it remains t divided by beta t. The corresponding value is equal to 1 by beta t. Magnitude is equal to 1 by beta, magnitude is equal to 1, 1 by beta. Dt will get cancelled, magnitude equal to 1 by beta. And the corresponding pace here is equal to 90 minus 90, which is equal to 0. This is equal to 0. Now, if you want to represent this in the polar plot, this on the polar plot, the angle is equal to 0 degrees to 0 degrees only, and the positive real axis only. Starts from the positive real axis and terminate at the positive real axis only. Okay, at omega equal to 0, the corresponding value is equal to 1. Corresponding magnitude is equal to 1, which is equal to your omega equal to 0. And at omega equal to infinity, the corresponding magnitude is equal to 1 by beta. The corresponding magnitude is equal to 1 by beta. 1 by beta means definitely it is less than 1. Since beta is greater than 1. This is the location of this 1 by beta. 1 by beta. So this is the value omega equal to infinity. Now what about the pace? What about the direction of this pace? Either in this direction, what we have to do? What we have to see? Here, listen. This is tan inverse of omega t minus tan inverse of beta omega t. This beta is greater than 1. Definitely the angle obtained from here is greater than the angle obtained from here. So definitely the angle may be negative only. So at omega equal to 0, it reaches to the omega equal to infinity like this. In this direction, it may reach you. Because the angle is negative here. Earlier, what we are having? Alpha of 1 plus ts divided by 1 plus alpha ts, where this is equal to tan inverse of omega t minus tan inverse of alpha omega t. Here alpha is less than 1 because of that this angle is positive. And omega equal to 0, the corresponding magnitude is equal to alpha. Alpha to 1, this is the shape we have taken in the earlier case, that is from omega equal to 0 to omega equal to infinity. Right or wrong? Omega equal to infinity, and this is the case for the lag point of view. Lag point of view, omega equal to 0 starts from 1 because this 1 by beta is definitely less than 1 since beta is greater than 1, and this is the corresponding shape. Okay, don't be confused in the examination. So don't remember in the examination also. Try to draw whatever the function they have given. Try to represent the corresponding magnitude and the pace. At omega equal to 0, whatever is magnitude, at omega equal to infinity, like your polar plot only. Don't consider as a one. Draw a polar plot for the system like that. Okay, which are the following represents the lead compensator? Which are the following represents for the lag compensator? Okay, very very important. There may be a possibility of getting the confused. If you try to put the option directly, okay, of course it may correct. Okay, it may correct. There may be a proper situation of an examination under the pressure. You may put the wrong answer. So don't go through like that. Just a simple do a one step. It will take 1 minute only. Less than one minute only. Now, what about the corresponding border plot here? Is there any initial slope? Definitely no. And the corresponding k value is equal to 1 only. So the magnitude is equal to 0 dB up to the first Carnot frequency 1 by beta t. Okay, here at beta t, this factor 1 plus beta t is in the denominator. So it is responsible for the beta t as a pole. Initiate the slope is equal to minus 20 dB. Up to what value? minus 20 dB up to what will next corner frequency which is equal to 1 by T. At 1 by T this is a zero term. So the corresponding poles offered by this zero term is equal to 20 dB. Minus 20 dB plus 20 dB. This will become 0 dB. This will become 0 dB. By adding some, by multiplying some factor, if you make to be shift this into the upwards, to shift into the supports, then it should be look like this. The corresponding actor is a by multiplying some factor of value greater than 1, then the plot shift upwards by that much of amount. Suppose if you multiply with 10, then the plot shift by 20 log is equal to 20 dB, then the shape will be looks like this. It is looking like a low pass filter. It allows the low pass frequencies and suspends the high pass frequencies. So the lag compensator acts as a low pass filter, whereas the lead compensator acts as a high pass filter. Now we are having the angle is going to be negative. At negative means at some particular frequency this will become minimum pace. At some particular frequency this will become the minimum pace. What is the corresponding pace we need to calculate? As like your earlier case also, for maximum or minimum, differentiation of the pi is equal to 0 only. Okay, differentiation of this pi is equal to 0 only. By doing this pi and make the differentiation and equate to 0, you will get the corresponding omega equal to simply here also the geometric mean of the corner frequencies only. So this is equal to 1 by t into 1 by beta t with the square root. So this value is equal to 1 by t root beta. 1 by t root beta only as like in the earlier case only. Okay, and the corresponding 1 by t root beta and the corresponding pi minimum is equal to same formula only. Sin inverse of 1 minus beta divided by sin inverse of 1 plus beta. Earlier case you are having sin inverse of 1 minus alpha divided by 1 plus alpha. And alpha is less than 1, definitely this is positive only. Here this beta is greater than 1. Definitely this is negative value. Because of that we are getting in this direction. So corresponding theta minimum is equal to sin inverse of 1 minus beta by 1 plus beta, and corresponding theta maximum here is equal to sin inverse of 1 minus alpha divided by 1 plus alpha from the point of view. Okay, if they ask you what is the alpha, then simply this is equal to sin theta equal to 1 minus alpha by 1 plus alpha. By doing the component and dividend or cross multiplying whatever, you have alpha is equal to 1 minus sin theta divided by 1 plus sin theta. You will get 1 minus sin theta by 1 plus sin theta. You will get, see, there also corresponding beta is equal to 1 minus sin theta minimum divided by 1 plus sin theta minimum. Whatever they ask you, you can read. This is simple mathematics only. But the designing point of view, this plays a very, very important role. Next one is a lag lead compensator. So it will act as a low pass filter. Lag lead compensator. Identification of the compensator is very important. The corresponding border plot is very important. Polar plot is important. At what frequency the maximum pace may occur, and what frequency the minimum pace may occur. What are the corresponding maximum pace and the minimum pace? Don't try to remember any formula. Even in examination also try to solve. Just try to expression and differentiate that one and the substitute the value whatever you got omega in the given expression. Now, lag lead compensator is equal to simply, this is a combination of first is your pole, 0, lag, and then 0 and pole. So this can be represented as the alpha of 1 plus T1S divided by 1 plus alpha T1S into 1 plus beta T1S, 1 plus T2S divided by 1 plus beta T2S. In this directly, T1 is equal to R1C1. And the T2 is your R2C2. In the spread correspondingly here, this value is equal to minus 1 by alpha T1. Okay, as it is a lag lead compensator, definitely we are having two types. We are having two types, the lead maximum pace and the minimum pace. If you draw the polar plot for this one, What you will get, you will get the sum maximum pace and the minimum pace, both you will get. This is the corresponding minimum, this is the corresponding maximum pace. At what value the minimum occurs, at what value the minimum occurs, simply geometric mean of these two. And at what value the maximum will occur, simply geometric mean of these two only. So the corresponding frequency you can call is equal to 1 by t2 root beta. What is the corresponding here? You have corresponding frequency equal to 1 by t1 root alpha. As beta is greater than 1, definitely this term is less than the this one, 1 by t1 root alpha only. This is the corresponding is whatever this magnitude point of view, how can you represent the initially this is the pole, initially this is the 0 dB up to some value. 0 dB up to some, if you not consider about the alpha, this is the some 0 dB up to some value, and after that, because of this pole, this is 20 dB, and because of the zero, again it is zero, and it is 20 dB, this is minus 20 dB, this is 20 dB, and you are having again zero, again for that, because of that, what is it? First one is zero. Because of this pole, you have minus 20 dB. Because of 0, you are having 0 dB. This 0 dB, and because of this pole, and because of this 0, again you are having 20 dB. And finally, you are having one pole. Because of that pole, again it is the. It is of 0 dB. 0 dB, 20 dB, minus 20 dB, here it is 0 dB, here it is 0 dB. By adding some constant value, we can shift the plot to be upwards like this, and it can act as a, we can allow some low frequencies and allow some high frequencies, but suspend some frequencies in between though. So this can be act as a band stop filter. It looks like a band stop filter. Okay, band stop filter. How? By adding some constant value to make this 0 dB to be moved upwards by some dB. This should look like this only. This is of the lag format low pass filter, and this is the lead format high pass filter. And we can call this act as a band stop filter. Okay, lead is the high pass filter, lag is the low pass filter, and your lag is compensated can be act as a band stop filter. The corresponding is equal to this one only. These frequencies, a particular frequency, this will be a minimum will exist. The corresponding frequency is equal to geometric mean of the two corner frequencies of this lag components. And here equal to 1 by t1 root alpha. See, this is also the maximum pace occurs at the frequency which is equal to 1 by t1 root alpha. This is the corresponding shape of the lag rate compensator and the corresponding gold of length for this one. Try to draw the corresponding polar plot for this one. For omega equal to 0, this value is equal to alpha only. By substituting omega equal to 0 in the magnitude, where we will get the corresponding magnitude is equal to alpha. So omega equal to 0, corresponding magnitude is equal to alpha. And at omega equal to infinity, omega equal to 0, the magnitude is equal to alpha. And omega equal to infinity, at that situation, omega equal to infinity, this part will become 1, and this corresponding part will become 1 by beta. So 1 by alpha is equal to 1 by beta only. Alpha equal to R2 by R1 plus R2, and beta equal to R1 plus R2 by R2, electrical representation point of view. Okay, so at that situation, this can be equal to, we can interrelate the omega equal to infinity, this value equal to 1 by beta only. First of all, this angle is going to be negative and reaches some minimum value, and it becomes maximum and reaches some minimum value at this omega equal to infinity. The corresponding value equal to 1 by beta, which is equal to alpha here, corresponding equal to 1 by beta, and this is the corresponding shape of this one here. Pace is equal to some minimum at some value. Okay, decrease negative minimum some value, and after that is going to be raises and the maximum at some particular value. At what frequency is the minimum? Is equal to 1 by t2 root beta. 1 by t2 root beta, and what frequency will be maximum? 1 by t1 root alpha. Getting 1 by t1 root alpha. If t1 is equal to t2, if we consider the corresponding t1 is equal to r1c1, which is equal to rc, you can call, and the corresponding t2 equal to R2C2. This electrical representation is equal to like this. That is lead followed by the R2 and the lag followed by this one. Electrical representation of this one is like this. So this is your C R. R1 C1 R2 C2. R2 C2 if you consider RC are equal RC RC. The corresponding T1 here is equal to R1 C1. T1 is equal to R1 C1 and T2 is equal to R2 C2. If you consider R1 R1 equal to R2 R2 and C1 is equal to C2, then T1 is equal to RC and T2 is equal to RC. Okay, T2 is equal to RC as we have beta is. As we have beta is 1 by 2 at the situation, alpha beta is equal to R1 plus R2 by R2. That is R plus R divided by, that is R plus R divided by, if you consider R1 equal to R2 and R1 equal to R2 and C1 is equal to C2, the corresponding beta is equal to 2 and the corresponding alpha equal to 1 by 2, 0.5. Corresponding alpha is equal to 1 by 2, 0.5. Okay, here T1, T2 are the same value. 1 by root alpha is equal to 1 by root 0.5. Because in the denominator, definitely this term will be greater than this term only, greater than this term only. So, first minimum will take place, followed by the maximum, followed by the maximum. That is, the graphical point of view, first lag, followed by this lead. Lag followed by this lead, electrical equivalent point of view, here this is our lead and this is our lag. Electrical circuit representation point of view. Okay. Similarly, the polar plot for the smaller values of omega, for smaller values of omega, minimum will take place at some value, which is equal to 1 by T root beta, and after that is maximum, and maximum will take place at some value, the corresponding equal to 1 by T1 root alpha, and finally reaches to omega pi equal to 0 degrees only, pi equal to 0 degrees only. So, this act as a band stop filter. Band stop filter, the importance is that in the examination point of view, the gate point of view, importance is that calculation of the identification of the frequency at what values the phase will be theta will be maximum and at what value theta will be minimum and what is the frequency and what is that value. Suppose g of s is given by 1 plus 3ts by 1 plus ts, 1 plus 3ts upon 1 plus ts. Gc of s is equal to Gc of s is equal to 1 plus 3ts upon 1 plus ts. What is the type of this compensator? Either lag compensator, lead compensator, or and if it is lag, then what is the corresponding minimum pace? And if it is the lead, what is the corresponding maximum pace? What is the corresponding maximum pace? Here, Carnot frequencies are poles of this bar, Carnot poles of the roots of this zero is located at minus 1 by 3t and pole is located at minus 1 by t, which is appears first because of 3 in the denominator, 0 will be appears first followed by your pole, so the corresponding frequencies are 1 by minus 1 by 3t and minus 1 by t, minus 1 by 3t and minus 1 by t, as 0 is appears first, so definitely it acts as a lead compensator, okay, it is not looking at the form alpha 1 plus ts divided by 1 plus alpha ts like that, okay. Don't consider the standard form. Standard form is for representation point of view only. Act as a lead compensator. At what frequency the maximum pace will appear? The maximum pace at omega is equal to geometric mean of these two. So 1 by t into 1 by 3t with square root. So the corresponding is equal to 1 by t root 3. Corresponding is equal to 1 by t root 3. What is that value? What is that value mean? Simply the calculation of this pi is equal to tan inverse of 3 omega t minus tan inverse of omega t minus tan inverse of omega t by placing this omega equal to 1 by t root 3 this equal to 3 into 1 by t root 3 into t minus tan inverse of 1 by t root 3 into t, 1 by t root 3 into t. What you will get? This is equal to tan inverse root 3, that is 60 degrees minus 30 degrees, which is equal to 30 degrees. 30 degrees is the maximum pace angle. The maximum pace angle appear by this lead compensator is equal to 30 degrees. Like that they may ask you many questions in the previous papers also. You are having some questions based on this one. Simply identify the corresponding zero and pole and the geometric mean of those two will produce the frequency where the maximum pace may occur. By substituting the frequency into the given pace, you can get the corresponding maximum pace. No need to remember any formula or anything.